Today I've got three different ways that you can manipulate and edit text using Adobe Illustrator that you probably didn't know about already. I guarantee you do not know every single way on this list today on how to edit text in Adobe Illustrator. Also, sponsoring today's video is Coursecraft, which is a great way for creatives like myself and you to design an e-course and sell it online. I'm going to be telling you all about Coursecraft at the end of this video, so if you want to make some money selling an e-course online and helping others, stay tuned until the very end of the video. Yo, what is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today I have three different ways that you can edit text using Adobe Illustrator that you probably don't know about. The first way to edit text in Illustrator does revolve around the whole outline function. Often we outline text so that we can edit the text and add effects. However, we're going to eliminate the need to outline the text so that we can actually still change the font and wording of the text itself. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to make a circle by pressing L for the ellipse tool and then holding down shift whilst clicking and dragging. If you press shift and X together, the stroke of the circle will flip over to a fill like so. I want to cut text into this circle here with the pathfinder tool. So we can press T for the type tool and place some text over the shape. I'm changing the color of the text so that I can see what I'm doing. We will need to select both the text and the shape and then use the minus front option in the Pathfinder window. But as you can see, when I use it, nothing actually happens. Often what designers will do is to outline the text or expand it, which would allow us to add the Pathfinder effects. However, this means we cannot make changes to the wording itself afterwards. So let's take some steps backwards and take a different approach in Illustrator. Select both the text and the shape before, and then hold down the Alt Option key and select the Pathfinder minus front option. This time you can actually continue to type in the text section and edit the font, the size, and even move it around the shape like so. This is non-destructive workflow in Adobe Illustrator. Next, I have yet more ways to edit text in Illustrator that you might not know about. This technique is again a way to eliminate the need to outline your text. If we have some text in Illustrator, we may want to add a gradient fill to it. So let me generate some text to show you guys. If I add a gradient to the color palette, you can clearly see the text remains black. I am going to make a shape to sample a gradient from. And if you're finding this tutorial useful, be sure to drop a like and a comment on the video. So even if I take the eyedropper tool to sample the gradient, the text still remains black. So instead of having to outline the text, which will restrict us from changing the wording of the text itself, go into the Pathfinder window, and in the top right corner, select the fly down menu. You then need to choose the compound path option. You can now add a gradient to the text without it being outlined, and of course you can change the font to any one you wish. This tutorial is enabling us as designers to add effects to our text without outlining the text, which is going to restrict us. If you take the gradient tool, you can also stretch the gradient across the entire design like so. Third and finally, I've got a great tip on editing text for your graphic design print projects. This one is thanks to Joe, who is a subscriber and a regular viewer to Satori Graphics. The issue we can have when saving a PDF for print in Illustrator is that the fonts we use, we either not have a license, or more importantly, when we send them to the printer, the computer that is used for printing will not recognize the font. So we often outline all the text and save it as a PDF. Problem again with this is that you cannot edit the wording of your text after outlining it. And also, if I open up the PDF in Acrobat and access the font section in the preferences, the font is listed here. If the printer does not have this font, there's going to be a big problem when printing your design. There is a way around this, which I'm going to show you now. In Illustrator, go up to Edit and Transparency Flattener Preferences. Click New here, and then drag the raster vector balance all of the way up. You also need to check the outline option. Oh, and also I forgot to say, you need to add a relevant name, something like outline or something like that. So now your text is still going to be editable, as we haven't actually outlined the text itself. But if you now go ahead and save the PDF, you must use the Acrobat 4 PDF option. And then in the Advanced window, choose the preference that you saved just now. When you export the PDF, you're not going to have any flagged warnings, and the PDF will not have fonts that another computer will not recognize. So essentially, we've outlined the text without actually outlining it. Now I'm going to show you all CourseCraft, who are sponsoring today's video. So if you want to make a course to sell online, stick around to see how to do that in a simple and effective way. You first need to make an account, which took me literally 20 seconds, and then confirm it via an email. To get started, it's very simple using CourseCraft, and the user interface is very simple and easy to use. Along the side here, you have bullet point lists of things to complete on your profile, as well as how to get started. To learn about CourseCraft in detail, you can also check out this link here on the 101. But to make a new course, you simply click Create New Course and give it a relevant name. I'm actually going to be using CourseCraft in the near future to publish in-depth courses that you're not going to see on YouTube, so stay tuned for that. So once you've created the course, you will then be met with this page here. If you click the landing page button, you can edit and control the aesthetics of your course landing page, and also what is displayed there and how it functions. You do have quite a lot of control over how your course will look visually on this page. And like I said, the user interface is very simple to use. Lastly, you can add a series of lessons within your course with the lesson list. You can add as many lessons as you like and build them up to fit your course. Obviously, you then want to upload the actual video content, adjust the pricing, and promote and manage your course or courses thereafter. So check out CourseCraft via the link in description if you're looking into selling a course online today. So there is today's video on three ways that you can use and edit text in Adobe Illustrator that you probably didn't know about. Let me know in the comment section below if you did actually know every single one of these methods using Adobe Illustrator, and also if you enjoyed today's video. I know the majority of my subscribers do actually enjoy Adobe Illustrator content the most. It's what I'm most comfortable in, and it's what I'm most professional in when it comes to Adobe software. But I do like to try and make a wide range of content on this channel here at Satori Graphics. So if you do like what I do, and you haven't done already, go ahead and subscribe for weekly graphic design content just like today's video. I upload videos 4 times a week, normally Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday. And if you have subscribed, make sure to turn on notifications by clicking the bell icon so you never miss an upload. I know YouTube doesn't show all of my uploads in people's news feeds, which sucks, but that's just the way it is. So if you click the bell icon, you're going to get a notification on your smartphone letting you know that I've uploaded the video. Also, of course, check out CourseCraft if you're thinking about making an e-course to sell online. It's a really good service, and I think you'd benefit from doing that. But anyway, until next time, design your future today. Peace.